Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah wa ba'd. Pagadatanku iwa takwanya sekali ni bapentayan tanong minister of local government yang sa biwangkwanya si attorney Najib Sinarimbo. Kepada pagadatanku watakwan tu a master of ceremony tamandukan kelangus kanu mengawataku mga apuku. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The topic given to me as of now is moral governance. I remember right that during the first session of the Bangsamoro Parliament, with the presence of the President of the Philippines, our Chief Minister had presented the governance of the Bangsamoro as moral governance to the President. And of course, we are now talking about moral governance. And in dealing with this topic, we have to be guided by the glorious Quran and the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Knowing that the glorious Quran have been emphasized by the glorious Quran is the best guidance. Verse number 9 of Surah Al-Isra. Yaqulullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna hadha al-Qur'ana yahdi lillati hiya aqwam. Surely or verily, this glorious Quran will guide you towards perfection. Just take note of the number of the verse, and then if you go home, yes, if you go home, you can verify it from the glorious Quran. Verse number 89 of Surah An-Nahl. يَقُولُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ. Allah said, O Muhammad, we have given you this book, that is the glorious Quran. We have revealed to you the glorious Quran. Tibyana li kulli shay, explaining everything. The glorious Quran is revealed to mankind and unfolded to man, the binominal book of nature, so that we can carry out research. None has been laid by the Quran unless it has been explained by the glorious Quran. And of course, we have to understand that the glorious Quran is the final word of Allah as our guidance in running our moral governance. It is the final word of Allah revealed to mankind through the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it is of eternal message, universal relevance, and everlasting punctuality. Of course, the glorious Quran has been complemented, detailed, or rather exemplified by the body of teaching of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which we describe as Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And these two, as our guidance, the glorious Quran and the Sunnah are accorded with infallibility, as emphasized by the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is saying, "Taraktu fikum amrayn, lan tadillu ba'di ma tamassaktum bihima. Kitaballahi wa sunnata rasulih. I have left for you two things which guarantees that you will never go astray. As long as you uphold them, they are the glorious Quran and the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Therefore, whatever differences of idea among us, especially in running the our moral governance, our final referee will be the glorious Quran and the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should not promote division and dissension among ourselves, but our final or best recourse is to refer it to the glorious Quran and the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Verse 59 of Surah An-Nisa. يَقُولُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. If you dispute on a certain issue, and then you have to refer it to Allah and the Messenger, that is the glorious Quran and the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In other verse 36 of Surah Al-Ahzab, يَقُولُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ. Being a believer, being a Muslim, male or female, we have no choice. We have no alternative. After the glorious Quran and the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had given their decision, but to comply with the decision of the two. Regarding the Sunnah, the glorious Quran is very explicit in negating our real faith unless we have to take, we have to adapt the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam as our final arbiter in whatever disputation among ourselves. Verse 65 of Surah An-Nisa. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. By your Lord, O Muhammad, they have no real faith. Unless they have to adopt you, they have to take you as their final arbiter in whatever disputation among themselves, without the least reservation of their heart in acknowledging your decision. وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. And they will submit to your decision with full submission. In the course of our discussion, we can find many verses of the glorious Quran as our basis, as our guidance in running the moral governance. The first, very first verse of the glorious Quran revealed to the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes like this: Iqra bismi Rabbi. You have to recite, you have to read in the name of your God. Here we are commanded not only to recite, not only to read, but to analyze what we are reading. Analyze what we are reciting. That is the message of the glorious Quran and the Sunnah to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and put them into practical life. While putting them into practical life, we should not forget the ethical side, the moral side in doing our job. In brief, in running our moral governance, there should be a balance between our academic skill in one hand and the moral side of doing our job in the other side. There are so many leaders who have passed away who are very skillful in their leadership, but because of the absence of moral governance, morality and spirituality in their leadership, instead of leading their people to prosperity and to success, they plunge their people into ruin and destruction. Another verse which can serve as our guidance or our basis in running the moral governance is verse 124 of Surah Al-Baqarah. يَقُولُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنْ قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا قَالَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي قَالَ لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Behold, when Prophet Abraham had been tried by God with certain command, one of these trials faced by Abraham was he was commanded by God to sacrifice his then only son Ismail alayhi salam. فَأَتَمَّهُنْ. All of these trials have been surmounted, that they have been overcome by Abraham, Prophet Abraham, in a perfect, in an excellent manner. So he was rewarded by his God. قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. O Abraham, I'm designating you as imam, as leader to entire mankind. That was the reward of God to Abraham alayhi salam. He has been appointed or designated as imam, as leader to entire mankind. Abraham pleaded, قَالَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي. Oh my God, not only myself to be leader, but even my progeny, even my offspring will be leaders. So Allah replied, قَالَ لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Even though they are your offspring, oh Abraham, if they are evildoers, if they are wrongdoers, my covenant will not be in the reach of those who are evildoers or those wrongdoers. So we can discern from this verse of the glorious Quran that in moral governance there should be no dynastic succession of leadership, as been practiced by some of our leaders in this area. Sometimes the leader will appoint his son or daughter as his successor without taking into account the efficiency of the successor. So we hope that we will be guided by the glorious Quran in the leadership of modern governance. Yes. Pasang imat tuan yang moro, ikat tua semoro. Yes, another verse that give us guidance is verse 135 of Surah An-Nisa. This verse guides us towards according justice in running our moral governance. Verse 135 of Surah An-Nisa. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله ولو على أنفسكم أو الوالدين والأقربين إن يكن غنيا أو فقيرا فالله أولى بهما الآية. Oh, you who believe, this is addressed to us, we Muslims, we believers. Oh, you who believe, you have to stand out firmly for justice as witnesses to Allah. Even though standing out for justice will be against our interest, our self-interest, our interest, or the interest of our parents, or the interest of our kids, our beloved one, or even against the interest of the rich or the poor. Because, you know, some people are inclined to favor the rich because they expect some good return from them. And some people are inclined to favor the poor because generally they are helpless. And both partiality in dealing, in our deal, is inconsistent with the Islamic practice and Islamic teaching. Another verse is verse 58 of Surah An-Nisa. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى إن الله يأمركم أن تؤدوا الأمانات إلى أهلها وإذا حكمتم بين الناس أن تحكموا بالعدل. الآية. Surely or verily Allah commands you to render the amana, the trust of Allah. You have been entrusted by Allah. And you have to render this trust of Allah to each proper place. For example, in choosing a leader. And then in our choice of leader, for example, through election, our vote is an amana. It is a trust of Allah. So you have to put your vote, you have to cast your vote to the correct candidate. And then the second half of this verse, وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَنْ تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ. Mr. Candidate, after winning the election, or after winning this election, and then if you judge among men, you have to judge in accordance with justice. Islam is a religion of peace. Islam is a religion of submission to the will of Allah. And this peace advocated by Islam has to imply justice and security and freedom. The freedom wherein the potentiality of individual is not being suppressed, wherein the principle of justice is not being compromised. Another verse regarding justice is verse number 8 of Surah Al-Ma'idah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu كونوا قوامين لله شهداء بالقسط ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. This again addressed to us, we believers, we Muslims. Oh, you who believe, you have to stand out firmly for Allah as witnesses for justice. And let not any aversion, not any hatred to anybody or hatred of anybody against you help you to depart from justice. You have to uphold justice, knowing that justice is next to piety, next to taqwallah. Wattaqullaha inna Allah khabirun bima ta'malun. So you have to fear Allah, knowing that Allah is well acquainted with what you're doing. In another verse, we have been advised or commanded by Allah to take provision, and the best provision is taqwallah, fear of Allah. Taqwallah means you have to do the commandment of Allah, and you have to abstain all what He forbids. Verse 197 of Surah Al-Baqarah. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى وتزودوا فإن خير الزاد التقوى واتقوني يا أولي الألباب. Oh, you who believe, you have to take provision wherever you go, then The best provision is taqwallah, fear of Allah. Another verse here which guides us in running our moral governance is verse number 2 up to 3 of Surah As-Saff regarding honesty. The verse goes like this: Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu lima taquluna ma la taf'alun kabura maqtan 'indallahi an taqulu ma la taf'alun. Oh, you who believe, why do you say something but you do another thing? It is grievously hateful in the sight of Allah that you say something but you are doing another thing. It is a sign of hypocrisy. It is a sign of dishonesty. You are promising something but you are doing another thing. You are not fulfilling your promise. We hope that the leadership of the moral governance will uphold justice and honesty. Yes. In another verse, verse 44 of Surah Al-Baqarah, أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنْفُسَكُمْ. Why do you enjoy men to do righteousness but you are forgetting to do it by yourself? There are so many people like this, and some leaders are doing it. They are enjoying men to do something, but they are to do righteousness, but they are forgetting themselves to practice what they are saying. Another verse here is verse 59 of Surah An-Nisa. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. It is unwavering loyalty to Allah and loyalty to the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And loyalty to Allah and loyalty to the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and loyalty